John the Baptist, Catholic Church, St. John of the Dakota, the city at the end of the rainbow. Eternal Father, we offer you the most precious blood of your divine Son, Jesus, in union with all the masses celebrated throughout the world today. For all the holy souls in purgatory, for sinners everywhere, for sinners in the universal church, those in our homes and within our families, amen. This holy sacrifice of the Mass is being offered at the intentions of Logan Lamas. And let's begin the sacrifice in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you grow the seed of faith in our souls. We know not how. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to cultivate this gift and produce good fruit. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your kingdom grows in and among us by mystery and grace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and honor and peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty God, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name most high, to proclaim your kindness at dawn, and your faithfulness throughout the night.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
The just one shall flourish like the palm tree, like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
They shall bear fruit even in old age, vigorous and sturdy shall they be, declaring how just is the Lord, my rock, in whom there is no wrong.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous. Although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land, and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Of its own accord the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, that when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them, as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them. But to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We enter back into ordinary time. This is the 11th Sunday in ordinary time. And traditionally, the 13th of June would be the feast of St. Anthony of Padua, but he is circumvented by Sunday. So for all those who carry the name Anthony, we wish you a bona festa. This was my father's name in my confirmation. And I'd love to hit the little story about how come all these men who were born with the name Anthony are called Tony? The story goes that when the Italians came over to Ellis Island, they had written T-O-N-Y on the head. And so they said Tony, but it actually meant to New York. Be that as it may. The 11th Sunday in Ordinary Time, Mother Church reminds us that as part of God's kingdom, the Church of Christ is like a tree planted by God in the world. And from the smallest of all the seeds, she becomes the noblest of trees and fills the earth. She is the physical evidence of God's kingdom. And so like the birds of the air, my brothers and sisters, we are called to make our home in her, in Mother Church. We look at the first reading, it's a message of hope. It's a message of restoration for us. And through the great prophet Ezekiel Yahweh, God promised to reestablish and to elevate his people who were in exile in Babylon. So this means that God wishes to transfer his people from a kingdom of oppression and poverty and misery to a realm of justice, of prosperity, of peace of mind. This is the kingdom where Christ reigns as king, and as the foundation of life. This is the kingdom where God wishes each of us to be. The church is a visible sign of this noble cedar, or the kingdom that gives refuge to all peoples. And if we look at the second reading from the great prophet and apostle to the Gentiles, Paul, he reminds us that we are on a journey, a pilgrimage towards the kingdom of God to be with Christ our Lord and King. So hence, whether we are living in the body or exiled from it, we must remain focused on pleasing the Lord. And the journey to this kingdom, it's a journey that must be approached with great faith and coraggio, with great courage. St. Paul reminds us, going as we do by faith and not by sight. So we are full of confidence and want to leave this body to be with Christ. And in light of this, we must advance diligently to be admitted into this kingdom of Christ. We look at this short but very profound gospel today. Christ is using two parables to describe the kingdom of God. The kingdom he invites us into is a very simple and a peaceful one. It's open to all people who seek it with a sincere heart. And the easiest way to enter into it is by sowing a seed of faith in Christ. That is the primary key. The second parable, the mustard seed, is the smallest seed. It refers to our faith. If you have faith like the grain of a mustard seed, nothing will be impossible for you. And so this includes entering the kingdom of God. However, it is important to note that the authenticity of our faith must be tested. Remember, you have an enemy. He's called Satan. He hates you. Be proud you have such an enemy. He will always try to test your faith, but we stay focused on Jesus. Faith grows And when it does, it achieves great things. And as it grows, it leads us to Christ and consequently to his kingdom. So our faith also draws others to Christ and to his church, the visible sign of God's kingdom here on earth. We are to be out of Christus. We are to plant seeds by our thoughts, our deeds, our interactions with people. We plant the seeds and we might not be around to see the fruits of it, but that's what we're called to do as Christians. We plant the seeds. Our faith draws others to Christ and to his church, which is the visible sign of God's kingdom here and now. Christ said that the birds of the air come to take shelter under its branches. So how does our faith draw others to Christ? Well, my brothers and sisters, when we truly demonstrate or bear a good testimony of our individual and collective faith, then the result is excellent. Lives can be touched and literally transformed and saved. Few persons might come to believe in God. Also, maybe a youth, he or she, might present themselves for a particular sacrament in the service to the church. A young couple might decide to sacramentalize their civil marriage in the church. Some might decide to give up a very old or a bad habit, while others might choose to forgive another. Others will go over and beyond to make sure that their children get baptized and brought into the church. Now, these may seem too insignificant as far as achievements, but the seed is growing. Consequently, this leads to the growth of the church. The church is a visible sign of God's kingdom on earth and will continue to be. And as our faith grows, the church, the body of Christ, grows, and more people are drawn into the comfort of God's kingdom. Now more than ever, the church of Christ is under attack. And it has been from when Jesus walked the earth, but even more so now. Hornhead, his tour of duty is coming to an end very soon, so he's throwing everything he can to try to conquer and divide. And the Lord is giving us this image of a seed. And a beautiful time of year here in this great state of North Dakota. By the grace of God, we've got some rains. Pastures are starting to green. Vegetables and flowers are starting to bloom. It's a beautiful image of the sprouting growth and the coming to fruition of the kingdom of God here in our midst. God wills that his kingdom come. And when we pray, my brothers and sisters, when we pray the Lord's Prayer, what does it mean when we pray for his kingdom to come? First, it means that God wants to come and dwell within each and every one of us, establishing his kingdom within our hearts, within our souls. So we must be living members of his kingdom, and he must be our ruler and our guide. This is why we pray for the grace to increase all the gifts and the fruits of the Holy Spirit so that we may truly work with God, that his will be done in, with, and through us for the salvation of souls. And then secondly, we understand this to be the establishment of his law and his will in our world. The supernatural law as well as the natural law. This means that the social, political, and cultural order must be transformed by God's grace so as to participate in and bear the fruit of his kingdom. My brothers and sisters in Christ, we are living in exciting times, in the end times, in biblical times, and we have an awful lot of work to do. Third, it means that we anticipate the final and the glorious coming of his kingdom. When Jesus returns in splendor, when he comes again in his glory, in the end all things will be transformed and God will bring forth his final judgment upon the world, making all things new. But this passage especially reveals to us how this will happen. It reveals that God's kingdom will slowly, gently, and miraculously take hold. This will happen in each of our lives. It will happen in our world as we Christians commit ourselves to this work of proclaiming the good news. And it will miraculously happen at the end of time when Jesus does return. Think about the image that Jesus gives us. The farmer plants the seed. And slowly it sprouts, grows, and produces fruit. And as this happens, the farmer knows not how. So today, when you have some time, reflect upon the mysterious ways that God establishes his kingdom. He's in charge of it first and foremost. But you and I, we have to do our part. We have to do our fair share. We must make our hearts and world around us fertile ground. We must plant the seed, water it as needed, but then let God do his part. God wants to bring forth his kingdom in your life, in my life, in everyone's life in the world, far more than any of us. But if you do your part, you also will be amazed as you watch grow his glorious handiwork of grace. It's all about saving souls, being out to Christus, to foster it, plant the seed, fertilize it through prayer, through fasting, through intercessory prayer, most especially, placing all of those family members and friends who maybe are not on fertile ground, and placing them on the altar sacrifice into the chalice of his precious blood, because he can do what we can't. But what we ask of him, God the Father, in the holy name of Jesus, with expectant faith, will be done. Amen.
Amen.
And become us. I invite you to stand with me now as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, for in all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us call upon God, our hope and our strength, and rejoice in the faith that draws us together.
For our Holy Father, that his prayers for the Christian unity and renewal be quickly fulfilled, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our President, Governor, Mayor, and members of Congress, that the Holy Spirit inspire and strengthen them in their service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students and teachers finishing the school year, that prayer, Eucharist, and charity remain on their schedule throughout the summer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those oppressed by any kind of need, that the Lord graciously grant them relief, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this body of believers, that we always aspire to please God and do his will, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, for all those we have promised to pray for, those who have asked for our prayers, and all the special intentions we hold in the deepest recesses of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, for all our family, our friends, and our parishioners who are suffering and struggling physically, emotionally, psychologically, and spiritually, for those who are battling addictions, for all those who are recovering from surgeries and those yet to undergo those surgeries, and for all who are living with terminal illnesses, we beg you to grant them the healing of mind, body, and soul, and to guard, guide, and protect all caregivers, all in the medical field, and our first responders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, for those who have died through the night and those who have died this very day, those who die a sudden, a violent, or an unprepared death, we beg you to have mercy on their souls. For all our deceased family, friends, and parishioners, that they may truly rest in your peace. For every holy soul in purgatory, we beg you to release these future saints, that they may join you, the church triumphant, and thus intercede for us, the church militant, in this ongoing spiritual battle for the salvation of souls, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Father Bill McCarthy and Jeanette Belgard, that they may truly rest in your peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in a special way in thanksgiving for Paul and Sarah Rahofsky, who were married yesterday, that God will give them many good, happy, and healthy years together, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of Logan Lannis, for whom this holy sacrifice is being offered today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Been gracious, loving, merciful, heavenly God and Father, truly confident that you hear and answer all prayers, both spoken and unspoken, we beg you today to infuse in us an abundance of all the gifts and the fruits and the charisms of the Holy Spirit, so that we may continue to be all due pieces to plant seeds and to help grow the church and your kingdom here. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Take holy therefore these gifts we praise by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. We may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Et ipso mecum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnes honor. Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a safe distance, silent peace.
Thank you.
God gives thee. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room. But only say the word and my soul shall be healed. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Our act is spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come, Holy Spirit, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Thank you.
Salmos Domine Deo Gracias. Blessed be God. Thanks be.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may you bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads for the blessing. May Almighty God always keep every adversity far from you, and in his kindness pour out upon you the gifts of his blessing.
Amen.
May God keep your hearts attentive to his words, that they may be filled with everlasting gladness. And so may you always understand what is good and right, and be found ever hastening along in the path of God's commands, made co-heirs for the citizens of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in our prayer of consecration to the two hearts. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, and most Immaculate Heart of Mary, you are one in purpose as you desire the salvation, holiness, and sanctity of each soul. We, the people of the Eternal Mountains, consecrate ourselves on our family's feet, seeking your victory both in our hearts and the world. May the river of the Father's divine love and mercy flow over your hearts, into our hearts, and through our hearts into the world. We acknowledge the perfection of your mercy, the abundance of your provision, and the supreme sovereignty of the Father's divine will. We desire to be part of your triumph and pray for our guests, the holy and divine Father. We wish for the help of your grace to live out this consecration, now and for eternity. Amen. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin, Virgin, my mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. A mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer thee. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan, all the unreal spirits throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Let us pray. O God, in your ineffable providence, you were pleased to choose blessed Joseph to be the spouse of your most holy mother. Grant, we beg you, that we may be worthy to have him for our intercessor in heaven, whom on earth we venerate as our protector, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Remember to pray hard, pray well, pray often. Save souls. Don't lose yours in the process. And
double
the Lord now. Amen?
Amen.
Next Sunday, Banner Day, Father's Day, Belcourt graduation, and Bishop Fuller will be coming to install me as pastor at our 10:30 Mass. It will be live streamed, followed immediately by our Summerfest little picnic out on the lawns. We will continue to pray for rain, for our livestock and our crops, but not on that Sunday. We won't allow it. Amen? There you go. Mani togi gosha wani make, make which. Sinshui chuklan, gizuwari konaron kwa. May God the Creator bless you. May Mary embrace you and protect you. Thank you for joining us. I love you, Mom. Be well. Have a God-glorious day today. Thanks, spring.